Activities. Now, before we begin, I'd like to clear up what seems to be a little confusion about the set here. You see, the eighth graders are putting on the musical Vaseline, and I gave my life. Oh, it's Greece. Well, anyway, I promised the children that we wouldn't disturb their handiwork during our benefit. So that's why things may seem a little incongruous at times. Now, we have a wonderful introductory song, but before we begin the festivities, let us ask the Lord to bless our endeavors. Sister, if you would.
Some folks think of comments as a places where we pray. All right! Sister, pay attention, I for you. Do you know what time it is? No, I always know what time it is. Because you see, back at the convent, we have this huge clock with the 12 apostles pasted on it. And I always know that when the big hand is on the John and the little hand is on the Peter. I'm praying! Hello! It's time for that quiz, my Reverend Mother! Warned you about! Now, here are the questions you should have the answers to if you were paying attention to that last song. Could I have some lights, please? Thank you!
Bye. to enter the convent, work my way up to Mother Superior, and turn the little sisters of Malfoken into the big sisters of Newark!
Well, my first lesson upon entering the convent was that we do not strive for position, just perfection. Besides, she who exalts herself shall be humbled, and she who humbles herself shall be exalted. Reverend Mother is the boss, and so I must obey, but as mistress of the masses, I shine in my own way.
Surely McLean,
oh babe, surely doesn't come. Well, that was just bizarre.
for the predicament that has brought us here today. You see, Sister Julia has never been able to get a handle on her vocation. Only last week we had the Monsignor coming over for dinner, so I asked Julia to prepare something a little special. A few minutes later, I see her in the kitchen and she's setting up an ironing board. I said, Julia, what the hell are you doing? She says, I'm gonna make pressed dough. Come on, folks, it ain't easy. We had 71 members in our order, and now we're down to 19. So I thought that possibly you know a little bit more about it.
Remember, Mother? I thought I was supposed to do this part.
Oh, my goodness, that's right. Amnesia's supposed to do this part. Go ahead. Go on.
Okay. Hello! My name is Sister Mary. Oh, for a minute there, I thought I remembered my real name. Anyway, I'm here to tell you what being a nun means to me. Can you hear me in the back?
Yes.
Good! Reverend Mother tells me that if I give a good talk, at least one of you will want to join our order. Well, I think it's just wonderful that you want to be a nun, and you think it might be fun to be one of the ones who is a nun. First, the order you give them to say, let us be. Why are you here? I thought you stayed in France with the Protestants.
No way, Jose. Girls, if you want to be a nun, join an order that still wears a habit.
Oh, now, sister, it's true that we still wear habits. But even I know a habit does not a nun make.
Get real, will ya? Hit it, sweetheart.
Virtues are always our concern. Think of all the solemn vows. There are three we must espouse: poverty, chastity, and obedience.
What the hell are you trying to do? Make me go deaf?
Oh, no, sister, don't be silly. You can't go deaf. Everyone can see. Nuns don't have ears. Oh, now where was I? Oh, yeah, thank you. Let's start with poverty. Empty your purse. Poverty makes being poor even worse. Granted, it's not so extreme for a nun. We may not be starving, but still it's not fun. Chastity is where we bow. Our posture is losing ground. You must be celibate. You can't scroll around. Obedience is number three. You cannot question what will be if you have no opinions to leave. Wait a minute.
Honey, 1935, and you weren't it. Now back to obedience.
if anything has happened. Go ahead. This is awful. Lord only knows what might have happened. Sister Hubert, I thought I told you to see that she reports everything to me.
Now don't try to blame this one on me. You're the one who bought the VCR.
Oh, let's not get into that. You know perfectly well I didn't realize there wasn't enough money.
We are sorry we cannot come
in. No, put us forward.
Sister Aunt Marie had to go down to the Board of Health for questioning.
Oh no, now you've really got it, Amnesia. Now you've really done it. What a mess you've gotten us into.
Well, I didn't mean to. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
Oh, Amnesia, hold on.
Regina, you didn't have to be so hard on her.
No, I didn't mean it.
Now, who would make sure she's okay? I tell you, it's not easy being Mother Superior. Trying to be a leader at these permissive times is almost impossible. Take Sister Robert Ann, please! Now, when she first came to the convent, they told me she was streetwise. Well, I thought that meant that she knew her way around town. This girl knows things you don't see on cable television. Why, just this morning she was in my office and she told me she was going to be writing a book for her gym class on feminine hygiene. Do you know what she's going to call it? A Catholic Girl's Guide to an Immaculate Conception. I tell you, it's not easy. Sometimes I wonder why I ever became a nun in the first place. I didn't have to, if that's what you're thinking. The other sisters don't know this, but I started out to be a tightrope walker. I'm not making this up, you know. My mother and father had a high wire act. They were billed as 2 tons on a tightrope. My whole family was a little bit on the hefty side. My father said, if we worked real hard, we'd be better than the Flying Willendas. All us kids were in the act, all except for Mary Claire. That's our sister. She took up with a contortionist. And one night, she was trying out this new position when a... Oh, dear. Never mind. I was telling another story. I was talking about the act. We got booked in London, and we had this wire stretched across the river as a publicity stunt. No net, mind you. 2 tons on a tightrope were up there when the wire snapped, and suddenly, boom, 2 tons in the Thames. Right then and there, I promised the Lord that if he saved them, I'd become a nun. How was I supposed to know he was going to come through? I mean, I thought they were goners for sure. Well, I figured since the Lord kept his part of the bargain, I'd better keep mine, so here I am. But you want to know the truth? Now that I'm here, I wouldn't have it any other way. But still, I've got to tell you, I see a spotlight. And though it's not right, I simply can't resist its call. Where some nuns of bingo at the parish hall. Turn up the spotlight and I have a ball. I lose my head then, I know what then when I start to hear that laughter crawl. Please, forgive me, but should I know? Absolutely marvelous!
Hey, Pete! You better try some of this! Have you ever felt it? It's absolutely wonderful! Have you ever tried it?
Can you try it?
Like to create other nuns.
nuns. For example, Sister Pocahontas, or your lady eagle,
Sister Heidi, right?
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, huh?
Yeah!
All right. I got one for you rock and roll fans, ready? Quick, Twisted Sister! Okay, all right. This next section here, I need a little audience participation, okay? I want you to guess the next couple of tricks. All right, now, if you know the answer, you don't gotta raise your hand or nothing, just call it out good and loud, okay? All right, I'm gonna give you a hint. Now, this first one here is from a movie. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi! You are my only hope! Yeah, you heard it! Star Wars, Princess Leia, the Chip of the Dome is on her head, right? She's coming! Good for you! Okay, so you did great with the movie thing, right? Now, I wanna test your theater knowledge. This is a Broadway showstopper. What is that? Phantom, yeah! Only around here I like to call it Phantom of the Convent, right? This next one, it takes a little bit of doing, so I need you to bear with me for just a second, okay? Father Joe, could I have some mood music for my nice friends up here? Yeah! Really good, thank you very much. Could you do me a favor and tell me if you see a large nun coming? Thank you. I appreciate it. Sometimes I do these tricks to my students. They think they're hysterical. Look, you know, they want to laugh. That's how I get through, you know, by being funny. See, I teach the seventh grade. Seventh grade, now that is a rough age to me. And I should know, too, because when I was in the seventh grade, I got sent to St. Clair School for the deplorable. And now, without further ado, the final impression of the afternoon. This is a Hollywood film classic. Wait till you see it. You're gonna love it. So you see, when you're not baking, it makes a wonderful devotional addition to your kitchen. Now, Amnesia here has designed a beautiful wooden stand for the book. Why don't you show us, Amnesia? Did you make that? She made that. All by yourself? All by yourself. Nice house. Nobody home. Many of our parishioners say the book is perfect for the top of the microwave. How comforting it must be to have our own blessed lady sitting on top of your lean cuisine. Now, should we take a look inside the book, sisters?
Oh, look!
The main section is just chock full of interesting recipes, perfect for the Catholic kitchen. For example, here's one. Caesar prawns, panis angelicus. A delightful taste treat consisting of two hot dogs wrapped in anchovies and served on a slice of Wonder Bread? Has anyone tasted this stuff?
Oh, why, no. We only saw the book today. We thought that you went over all this with Julia.
I don't know this network with us. Well, it's too late now, isn't it?
In a word, yes.
Leave right alone. Here's one. Mortally sinful devil's food cake.
Oh, isn't that cute?
Wait, here's one. Mary Magdalene tarts. I bet they're easy. Tarts? Tarts? Zoom! Zoom!
Oh, look at this one. Here's one for Girl Scouts.
Why don't you read that one, sister?
Okay.
Sister, out loud.
Okay. First, get 12 brownies real hot.
That must be a mystery. I'm moving on to another section. Oh, here we go. Historic recipes. Barbecue ribs. St. John.
They're even flambé.
Everyone go to church today? Better make sure you do.
We'll be right along.
Now here's a good one. Leg of lamb of God.
It says here that these are the hors d'oeuvres served at the Last Supper. Host toasties! It serves 13!
Oh, look at this one! Five cross knobs! Oh, that Julia! She's a real killer!
Man, there's so many delightful tasty treats in here, we don't know where to begin!
You know, the book will be available after our program this afternoon, and I'm sure that you'll all want to get your own personal copy.
Sister Julie asked that all the props from the book go to the burial fund!
Holy smoke!
What's the matter?
Something burning?
No! She's included the recipe for that soup!
What?
Look here! Bichiswa soup!
Well, the recipe's a poison, isn't it?
How am I supposed to know? I should have known better than to trust that nitwit to do anything. Well, we can't sell this thing.
Well, what are we going to do? We're counting on the books to bring in some extra money.
I'm going to talk
for my fire.
Oh, no fire.
What is that something special? I don't believe it.
You mean it?
Yes, I know. You know, whenever I change my mind.
I promise.
When I became a nun at a very early age, I choose between the convent and a life upon the stage. So when Reverend Mother said we're putting on a show, I was telling you, I was thrilled to death. I couldn't wait to go. But then to my surprise, Reverend Mother didn't see what is so obvious. The stage was meant for me. Money and fame I don't desire. I only want a sparkle. I'm not here to start a fire in me. I don't care if I've never been so famous. I just wanna be a star.
I tried it all and hope I said it was more than fair. Even though I lost your mind, I think that's Amen.
Kerry Paul would leave her in France. But when we got back, no one remembered what happened to her. And then you mysteriously appeared, but all you could tell us was that a crucifix fell on her head. So your sister, Mary Paul. I guess that ends the hope of her being a Franciscan.
Now, Sister Mary Paul, do you remember everything?
Oh, yes, I think I do!
Ah! You see, there was this contest, and I had a chance to go to Nashville. This is how I was doing becoming a nun. I'm sure Stigma, you all felt.
Oh, of course.
Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! Sister Mary Paul was the name of the nun who won the Publisher's Clearinghouse sweepstakes, but they could never find her. That's you! The important thing is we get to send those sisters off to claim their heavenly reward.
And we can get back to concentrating on our own heavenly rewards, because each and every one of us here today has the potential to become a saint.
And you want to know something?
What?
It's not that hard to be a saint. All you've got to do.
Thank you.
Because I feel like a holiday.
Woo! Yeah!
Sing it, girlfriend!
Because I'm calling out.
How is me? Yes, I don't look that good when I move, but still. Do you like the way I look? I think I do. Now, if you want...
A zero, 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 zero.
Yeah!
Why not? Oh, and you can see that I've been moved by just a person. Oh, Big Al's Monster Book. That's not my name. That's the author of the book. Anyway, in Big Al's Monster Book, you'll see monsters from A to Z and 1 to V. Well, there's no such thing as that. But, anyways, do you like monsters? Then come to our greatest carnival in the world, Monsters Galore!